A Sydney widow is celebrating after a court ruled she could access her dead husband's frozen sperm in order to conceive. Jocelyn Edwards' husband Mark died just a day before the couple planned to sign up for IVF.
There have been few reasons for Jocelyn Edwards to smile since losing her husband Mark, but today's judgment definitely provided one.
I'm so happy. I can't believe it's gone my way.
The couple had long wanted a child together and were booked into an IVF clinic last August to make their dream come true. But on the day before their appointment, Mr. Edwards was killed in a workplace accident. So although their interest was clear, they hadn't yet signed consent forms. It was left to the Supreme Court to rule on Mrs. Edwards' claim for possession of frozen sperm extracted from Mr. Edwards' body.
It entitles her to take possession of her late husband's sperm, which has been frozen, and that's it.
Champagne. More champagne at this point, just for today.
Mrs. Edwards can't wait to celebrate, but her battle to fall pregnant isn't over yet. While she may have won access to her late husband's sperm, she'll still have to navigate fertility laws, restricting how, if at all, it can be used. Each state has different laws, and Mrs. Edwards would have to travel out of New South Wales to overcome restrictions here relating to her lack of written consent.
IVF clinics in New South Wales will always obtain written consent from both partners for the use of either eggs or sperm or any embryos created from them, because clinics think ahead to deal with this issue.
Mrs. Edwards is determined to find her own way through the legal maze.
We're going to have our baby.
Amber Muir, 10 News.